Skeletal system. Everything you should know and interesting facts you didn't know. Welcome to the channel, anatomy lovers. We aim to help you better understand the human body and how it works, both theoretically and practically. Let's start with something basic. How many bones does the human body have, and how are they distributed in different body parts? There are varying figures when discussing the total number of bones, because some sources count the sacrum as 5 separate bones and the coccyx as well. However, since both of these are typically considered single bones, we can agree that there are 206 bones in the adult human body. Here's a breakdown of the bones by body part. The skull and associated bones have 29 bones. The pectoral girdle contains 4 bones. The thorax has 25 bones. The spine consists of 26 bones. The upper limbs have 60 bones. The pelvis has 2 bones. And the lower limbs also include 60 bones. Some of the essential bones that contribute to the shape of the skull include the frontal bone, parietal bone, occipital bone, temporal bone, nasal bone, maxilla, and mandible. The bones of the skull in newborns are not fully fused at birth, which allows for easier adjustment during childbirth and room for the brain to grow in the first years of life. The spine, or the vertebral column, is a supportive pillar of the body that provides structure, balance, and flexibility. It protects the spinal cord, which carries essential nerve signals between the brain and the rest of the body. The spine comprises 33 to 34 vertebrae divided into 5 regions: cervical, thoracic, lumbar, sacral, and coccygeal. This structure allows for a wide range of movements while bearing much of the body's weight. Additionally, the spine acts as a shock absorber, with intervertebral discs cushioning each vertebra, making it crucial for posture and overall mobility. The spine features several natural curves that are important to remember, including cervical lordosis, thoracic kyphosis, lumbar lordosis, and sacral kyphosis. In contrast, scoliosis refers to an abnormal sideways curvature of the spine. The cervical spine consists of 7 vertebrae. The thoracic spine has 12. The lumbar region contains 5. The sacral region has 5. And the coccygeal region has 4 to 5 vertebrae. Did you know that the most common issues in the lower back occur between L4 to L5 and L5 to S1? This is likely because these areas have the most mobility and are thus more prone to injury. Each vertebra plays a vital role in supporting the body and protecting the spinal cord. The main components of a vertebra include vertebral body. The thick, weight-bearing part is at the front. Vertebral arch, the bony ring at the back that encases the spinal cord. Spinous and transverse processes, bony projections that serve as attachment points for muscles. Facet joints, small joints connecting each vertebra, allowing for flexibility and movement. Intervertebral disc, a cartilage cushion between vertebrae that acts as a shock absorber, consisting of the annulus, fibrosis, and nucleus pulposus. Interestingly, when you wake up every morning, you may be 1 to 2 centimeters taller, if you have had enough sleep. This height increase is due to the nucleus pulposus being hydrated overnight, but its hydration tends to decrease with age. The rib cage, also known as the thoracic cage, is a fascinating structure that protects vital organs while supporting respiration. Here are some interesting facts about it. True ribs. The first 7 pairs connect directly to the sternum via costal cartilage. False ribs. The following 3 pairs connect to the sternum indirectly through the cartilage of the ribs above them. Floating ribs. The last 2 pairs do not connect to the sternum at all, allowing for greater flexibility during movements like bending and twisting. Flexibility for breathing. The rib cage is not rigid. It is designed to expand and contract as we breathe, allowing the lungs to fill with air. The cartilage between the ribs provides this flexibility, enabling vital respiratory movements. The sternum is made up of three main parts: the manubrium, the top part, the body, the central portion, and the xiphoid process, the small tip at the bottom. This structure aids in anchoring the ribs and stabilizing the rib cage. The scapula, or shoulder blade, is a flat, triangular bone located on each side of the upper back. It is an essential part of the shoulder complex, allowing for a wide range of arm movements. Here are some interesting facts about it. Some parts of the scapula include the infraspinatus fossa, supraspinatus fossa, subscapular fossa, and the inferior and superior angles. Interestingly, it is not directly attached to other bones through joints and can move in six different directions. The clavicle, or collarbone, is a long, slender bone that connects the arm to the trunk of the body, playing a crucial role in shoulder stability and movement. Sternal end connects with the sternum, breastbone, at the sternoclavicular joint. Acromial end connects with the scapula, shoulder blade, at the acromioclavicular joint. The clavicle is one of the most commonly fractured bones in the body, particularly among children and athletes. Humerus. The humerus is the long bone of the upper arm, featuring a rounded head that forms the shoulder joint and a distal end that connects to the radius and ulna at the elbow. It is the largest bone in the upper limb and has two necks, the anatomical neck and the surgical neck, where most fractures occur. The forearm consists of two bones that have the unique ability to cross over each other, enabling the twisting motion of the forearm. When you rotate your forearm to turn your palm up, supination, or down, pronation, the radius crosses over the ulna. Interestingly, the radius is shorter than the ulna near the elbow, but longer near the wrist. The wrist and hand contain 27 bones, which are divided into three categories: carpal bones, 8 bones, scaphoid, lunate, trichetrum, pisiform, trapezium, trapezoid, capitate, hamate; metacarpal bones, 5 bones; phalanges, 14 bones, as the thumb has only 2 phalanges. The pelvis is composed of 3 bones on each side: the ilium, ischium, and pubis. An interesting fact about the pelvis is that it serves as a crucial structural foundation for the entire upper body and plays a significant role in our ability to walk upright. It also protects vital organs such as the bladder, intestines, and, in females, the reproductive organs. The pelvis has a remarkable gender-specific adaptation. In females, it is wider and has a broader inlet and outlet to facilitate childbirth. Femur. The femur consists of a head that fits into the hip socket, a neck, a shaft, and 2 large bony protrusions called condyles at the distal end, which form the knee joint. The greater and lesser trochanters are significant regions of the femur, as they serve as landmarks and are important for muscle attachment. Interestingly, the femur is the longest and strongest bone in the body. Tibia. Known as the shin bone, the tibia is the second largest bone and the primary weight-bearing bone of the lower leg, featuring a proximal end that forms the knee and a distal end that connects to the ankle. It bears most of the body's weight during standing and movement. The tibia's strength and structure are essential for absorbing impact forces when we walk, run, or jump. The lateral and medial epicondyles and the medial malleolus are important landmarks on the tibia. Patella. The patella is the largest sesamoid bone in the human body, meaning it is embedded within a tendon. It acts as a shield for the knee joint, protecting it from direct trauma, and also serves as a lever that enhances the power of the quadriceps muscle, making knee extension, straightening, more efficient. Fibula. Although it is thinner and more delicate, the fibula plays a significant role in stabilizing the ankle and supporting the muscles of the lower leg. Interestingly, it is not directly involved in weight-bearing, unlike the tibia, but instead provides attachment points for various muscles and ligaments. The fibula also acts as a shock absorber for the lower leg, distributing force during impact. The end of the fibula, on the lateral side of the ankle, is called the lateral malleolus, serving as a useful landmark. Like other bones, the fibula has its head at the proximal part. Worth noting is the interosseous membrane that connects the tibia and fibula. Foot. An interesting fact about the ankle is that it consists of two joints, the subtalar joint, where inversion and eversion occur, and the talocrural joint, which allows for dorsiflexion and plantar flexion. We will discuss these in more detail in our upcoming video about the joints in the human body. The foot contains 26 bones, which are divided into tarsus, talus, calcaneus, navicular, cuneiform I, cuneiform II, cuneiform III, and the cuboid bone, metatarsus, 5 bones, phalanges, 14 bones. Here are some basic concepts that are useful to know, both in general and for understanding issues related to your body. Osteology, a branch of anatomy that studies bones. Os, Latin term for bone. Osteoblasts, cells that form new bone. Osteoclasts, cells that break down bone tissue. Osteocytes, cells within bone tissue that help maintain it. Proximal, closer to the center of the body. Distal, further away from the center of the body. Fracture, a break or crack in a bone. Ossification, the process of bone formation. Osteomyelitis, an infection of the bone. Osteoporosis, a condition characterized by reduced bone density, making bones more fragile. Articulation, a joint or connection between two bones. Periosteum, a membrane covering the outer surface of bones. Epiphysis, the end part of a long bone, often containing cartilage for growth. Diaphysis, the shaft or central part of a long bone. Metaphysis, the transitional area between the epiphysis and diaphysis containing the growth plate. Feel free to answer the following 5 questions to test your understanding and see how much new information you've gained. Let us know in the comments how successful your answers were. 1. What is the biggest and strongest bone in the human body? 2. What is the second biggest bone? 3. How many bones are in the foot? 4. How many bones does the human body have in total? 5. Which bone is the most commonly fractured? We look forward to seeing you in our next video. Stay healthy and educated with the Anatomy Lovers Channel.